What's happening, Bomb Community? Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you guys are when you're watching this. It's been a little bit since my last video, and honestly, most of the time, usually I'm uploading collection update videos for you guys. But since my recent trip to Charlotte, there hasn't really been much in the way of new acquisitions, so I thought I'd try a little bit of a change of pace for this video. And this is what this video is going to be consisting of, is my top 10 most valuable records in my collection, and each one has a story involved with it. If you're curious about what's playing in the background, this was actually one I brought back from Charlotte with me. This is It's Alright, Went and Kelly Trio on Verve, featuring Went and Kelly, Paul Chambers, Jimmy Cobb, Kenny Burrell, and Candido. Great album. If you guys are new to my channel, and for those of you that have been with me since the start, you'll know that I preach the gospel of Verve Records a lot. Their jazz stuff is slept on a lot, and it's, a lot of it can be found at a really good price. This one tends to be a little bit more expensive just because it's a little bit harder to find in good shape, but great album, and I absolutely love it to death. This is actually the first time I get to drop the needle on this one since I brought it back from Charlotte. So that's what's going to be playing in the background for most of this video. But to start out with, this whole stack is just nothing but bangers, and I'll try to share with you, keep it brief, but I'll try to share with you a little bit of a story on each one of these. But the first one is A9160 on Impulse, Elvin Jones, Richard Davis, Heavy Sounds. This is my first pressing stereo that I acquired around, I think, November, December last year. And absolutely amazing album. These tend to go in good shape around the 150 to 250 mark. And honestly, it's one of those that, depending on when you look, it can be difficult to find, especially in good shape. This one is almost pristine. I mean, the jacket's stunning and the wax plays really clean. And for me, what attracted me to this album was specifically the track, the title of the track, Raunchy Rita, which honestly the title is perfect. It's stanky, loud, obnoxious, and love it to death. But what's interesting for me about this particular album is side two, track A, the track one, almost sounds like they're warming up for side A. And I just found it very interesting that like side B sounds nothing like side A. But that's kind of typical of the jazz world, especially in the post-bop era. But great album. It's been reissued a few times. I hope at some point maybe Acoustic Sounds will do a reissue of this, but it's highly unlikely. So it's just one of those you just keep an eye out for. You can find represses, like I said, a little bit cheaper, but an original pressing will run you about $150 to $250, depending on condition and everything else. There are white label promos for this album, like a lot of them. One of them went up on eBay, I think around November, around the same time I purchased this one, and sold for about $650, which is pretty standard for a lot of white label albums, just because they're as close to the original puck as possible. Because what you tend to have is you tend to have the test pressing to make sure everything's where it needs to be, and then you have the white label promo slash radio station copies, which are the next ones in the line. So they're pretty close to the original tape, and then you have the standard pressing, so they tend to go for a little bit more, and rarity is also a big part of that. But great album, and it's one of my absolute favorites and one of my best pickups from last year. The next one, although it is not a true first pressing, it's still equally as hard to find, and I got a smoking deal on this one. This is a Blue Note 84152, Joe Henderson, Our Thing. This is a second pressing stereo. So it's missing the ear, / Plastilite P. But it features Kenny Dorham, Andrew Hill, Eddie Kahn, and Pete LaRocca on this album. Joe Henderson's stuff really needs no introduction. It's all his stuff is absolutely amazing, and he's one of those artists I discovered later, and I actually have to give a special thanks to Chris at Tunes from the Man Cave for introducing me to Joe Henderson's work. And ironically enough, that's how I acquired this album. Chris was actually looking for an original pressing of this, and this album was sitting at Leash Pit Records in Colorado Springs since my trip last summer. And I was like, I think that album's still there, and I think it's an original pressing. It was at an amazing price, which I'll get to in a minute. But reached out, Adam at Leash Pit sent me pictures of it, and at the price, I was like, okay, well, I reached out to Chris. It turns out it's a second pressing. So he's holding out for that OG, and frankly, I can't say I blame him. But it left an opportunity for me to pick this up. And so I made a deal with Adam, sent him the money for the low, low price of $115, which honestly, in the condition that this album's in, this is a steal. First pressings of this album, generally, I've seen as high as $400, $450. This particular pressing, I've seen as high as $250. And they don't come up very often. I think the last one of these that came up for sale was like around summer of last year as far as Discogs go, and you just don't see them on eBay at all. Pretty much all of Joe Henderson's albums, you just, especially the Blue Note ones, you just don't see come up for sale very often. And I can understand why. Great album, and highly recommend it. It's been reissued quite a few times, so you know, if you don't want to spring for an original or even a second pressing like this one, you can find a reissue pretty easy. But absolutely amazing album, and I hope to acquire either a second pressing, or you know, maybe if the vinyl got a smile on me, a first pressing of Inner Urge this year. So we'll see on that one. But yeah, great album. The next one was actually an acquisition right before I went to Charlotte, and again, Chris introduced me to this artist as well. This is Blue Note 4137, Jackie McLean, One Step Beyond. This is an original mono pressing, Plastilite P, the whole ball of wax. And actually, this album has been steadily creeping up. Generally, they go around the $250 mark, which is what I paid around that for this through a seller on Instagram. And it's an interesting album. It's right at that edge of experimental at times. Most of Jackie's work tends to be more on the hard bop side, and this one almost experiments a little bit with outside of that realm, but great album. And while it's one of the more easier ones to find on the Blue Note category, or Blue Note label, excuse me, it tends to be a little bit more expensive, because they, like a lot of the Blue Note titles, a lot of them are beat compared to the ones that aren't beat. So generally, almost every Blue Note title tends, especially the early ones, tend to command a little bit more money. But great album, and honestly, if you can find it, definitely don't hesitate on picking this one up either. This one's been reissued countless times, and it's not that hard to find, but you know, to find an original, if you don't want to, again, you don't want to spend money on an original or second pressing, that's fine. Just find a cheap original. I think it's been released on the Classic series. There's been countless pressings through the years. Again, great album. This one is actually my most recent acquisition, and it came right around the time that I left for Charlotte, same as the Jackie. This is the Max Roach Trio featuring Legendary Hassan, ATL-502A, on Atlantic. What's interesting about this particular album is this is not a U.S. pressing. This is actually an original U.K. pressing, which is actually a little bit more valuable than the U.S. pressing. Max Roach is a legendary drummer. I love his stuff, just right alongside Blakey. I think they're neck and neck a lot of times, depending on what release I'm listening to. But not a lot is known really about Hassan. And it's one of those that I did not know anything about. And again, sort of theme of this video. And honestly, he's one of the guys that just, he's given me so much knowledge as far as jazz goes. Chris of Tunes from Man Cave exposed me to this album as well. And I've tried bidding on US copies a couple different times and just always got outbid at the last time. It's a little bit one of those harder titles to find. And this original UK pressing turned up in the last Solo Vinyl sale. Solo Vinyl, if you guys aren't familiar, is a store out of New Mexico. They set up shows, they do pop-ups and stuff like that, but they also though have been known for doing Instagram sales on a fairly regular basis. I think they're taking a break right now. But this one turned up in their last sale, and it's squeaky, squeaky clean. And I reached out and was able to snag it when the sale went live. This particular version, or pressing of the album, currently is listed on Discogs for right around $250 to $350 for the higher grade copies. Generally VG and G are, you know, $150, that kind of thing. But for a copy of this kind of quality, which is near mint on the wax, you're talking on the higher end for sure, around, you know, about $275-$300. But great album, not one that's been reissued quite a lot, so probably hence the price on the pressing and stuff. But great album if you can find it, and don't hesitate to pick this one up. I think you can get a US pressing for around $100 in VG Plus, but the great album sounds absolutely amazing. A little bit of a change of pace now to rock. So this one actually came by way of Leech Pit Records as well, and this one has been steadily creeping up in price. This is Kane, Pound of Flesh. This is a 1975 first stereo press. Honestly, not really much can be said about them. It's just it's a private press hard rock album. I believe this is the only album that they ever did. I actually learned about this one through Dylan at Noble Records, and I got this one for right around $85. This album has been recently selling in the $150 to $200 price range. Some of those prices might be artificially inflated, but you know, that's just the way the market's been. But great album, and not one I don't think that's ever really been reissued, at least officially. So keep an eye out for this one. It's a pretty easy album cover spot. Obviously, you know, raw meat and stuff like that. Love this album, play on a fairly regular basis. This next one is actually one that came to me as a Christmas present. It's one that really needs no introduction. It's been released countless times. It's on so many top 100 lists. Let's just get to it. Velvet Underground and Nico, Andy Warhol. This is my third pressing third state / airbrush pressing. Super, super clean on the wax. Obviously it's missing the banana. And I came through this one by way of eBay. Just took a chance at the last minute, put the bid in, got it for well under what I believe this album would go for in its condition. Third states generally hover around the $200 to $250 price range. First states, the Emerson covers, if they're in good shape, they're $750,000. Second states, $550 to $750, depending on condition, stuff like that. But it's an amazing album. It's again highly influential, and at least when it came out, pretty controversial for its time. And that's saying something considering it came out in the late 60s. But one of my absolute favorites. I hope at some point to upgrade to one which actually has the peel on it, but can't play the cover. So I'm very, very happy with this album. This next one is one that you guys are probably not going to be that familiar with, but it's an absolute fire. Fireball, and it's one that's been reissued, I think, in the last couple years. So this is Rain Man. This is a 1971 first Netherlands pressing, and on Negrim Records. It's one of those that is not, like I said, flies under the radar, but it's a psych folk slash rock. This one was issued with an original inner that unfortunately this copy did not have. This one came in by way of Europe, which is basically the only place you can seem to get original pressings of this album. And it's sort of all over the place. At times it sounds a little bit like George Harrison. At times there's blues rock. It's all over the place. But great album. It's one of my absolute favorites. And this came in by way of a Discogs seller out of Europe. And again, aside from a little bit of staining on the top cover, pretty dang clean. And it's one of those I was very happy to get a copy of, and maybe at some point I'll be able to get one of the whole deal with the inner and stuff. But if I can't, that's fine. This next one, actually, I discovered through Mike at the In Group. I was watching a update video of a collection he had purchased that had a lot of rare stuff in it. And this one he said he bought just because it looked interesting. And it is. It's very interesting. It's very good. This is Banshee Thinking. This is a U.S. pressing, U.S. stereo pressing on Polydor. This was released in the UK and in America. Just great late 60s, early 70s hard rock. They put out, I believe, two albums. The first one's kind of meh to me. This is the one that actually sticks out. And again, around the $150, $175, $200 price range. I got this one right around $100. I shot the seller an offer on Discogs, and he took it. Great, like I said, great rock album. A little bit of medieval influences in there. The cover's kind of a dead giveaway. But again, great album, highly, highly recommended. These last two are absolute grails of mine, and honestly, if I had to sell everything else, these two wouldn't be my collection. This next one has been featured on so many of my videos on this channel, and it deserves it. And the only way I would get rid of this one is if I select it to an original mono. This is John Coltrane, I Love Supreme, A77 on Impulse Records. It features John Coltrane on tenor sax, McCoy Tyner on piano, Jimmy Garrison on bass, and Elvin Jones on drums. This album, like the Velvet Underground and Nico, is on so many top 100 lists, and it has every right to be there. This, to me, he's put out so many great works in the short time he was on this planet, but to me, A Love Supreme is Coltrane's masterpiece, his undisputed masterpiece. I've said it once, and I will say it till the day that I die. For those of you that aren't really big jazz guys, jazz fans, this album is essentially Coltrane's letter to the man upstairs. Whether you're religious or not, that's how it is. In fact, when you open up the jacket, it sums it up perfectly. It's just an absolutely amazing album. I looked into this one out of seller out of Europe. There's a period where this album was kind of difficult to find online through U.S. sellers, so I just took a chance through a dealer out of, I think it was Belgium, and this one took about 2.5 weeks to get here, and I was so excited to get this. This album, stereo pressings have been creeping up. Like, this one tend to go around the 250 range, maybe 300. Mono pressings have skyrocketed. They are minimum $550 to $650 all day long. I've seen them go as high as 8 for super clean one. And I hope to upgrade Micah's copy to an original mono. I have owned original monos, but they weren't near as clean as this one was. Jacket-wise, it's got a little bit of a booger at the top here. And a little, very little bit of laminate wear on the very, very edge. Not bad. But the wax on this sounds amazing. Solid VG Plus condition. And it's one of my absolute favorite albums. I play this probably 3 times a month. It's just one. It's one of those albums that just puts you in a place in your mind, and you just feel a lot happier, a lot more at peace once this album's done playing. And so, it's at the very top of this video, and just like it's placed on so many lists, it deserves to be there. The final one was a recent acquisition, within the last couple months. Again, probably I think around the time I went to Charlotte. Very, very difficult album to find an original pressing of, and a lot more difficult to find in clean condition. Band that has not commercially did not make it big, but has been highly influential to many bands that have. This is Introducing the Sonics, featuring The Witch and Psycho. This is the second album that the Sonics put out on Jordan Records. This is an original mono pressing, super, super clean. This album is just pure garage rock fire. Their albums are great. It's interesting that this album came out in 67, because to me it sounds like it's a couple years earlier. This sounds like it would have come out in 65 based on how they sound and everything else, but yeah, this album came out in 67. This album sells for between $350 to $550. I got this one by way of eBay through a seller. He had this listed at $300 or so, and I had put it in my watch list, and what eBay will do is it'll notify the seller, and sometimes the seller will mark it down temporarily to get your interest peaked. And he marked it down a little bit more and sent him a couple questions. He sent me pictures to the best of his ability, and I took a chance. Got it in the mail. The album is squeaky clean. The only issue it's got is the jacket's got a little bit of a bend from probably sitting cockeyed in somebody's shelf, but I wouldn't be able to touch this album in this condition for less than $400 generally. So this is so far one of my best pickups for 2022, and that's the reason why it's at the very top of the list. And I mean, my favorite track from the Sonics is Psycho. It's just a great album. It's almost on the verge of being manic at times on that particular track, but great album, and it's one I think that's been reissued quite a few times. Obviously, if you don't want to spring for an original, especially for the prices that they fetch, obviously get a reissue. You can't go wrong with it. But yep, this is number one for my list of top 10 most valuable records in my collection. But hope you guys enjoyed this video with me. If you like what you see, please click like and subscribe. It's been a pleasure speaking with you as always, and we'll talk again soon. You guys have a good one.